Well, the CFMEU has placed its Victorian branch into administration following allegations the organisation was overrun by underworld figures. And this morning, there are claims the Victorian Premier and Prime Minister were sent evidence backing these allegations 18 months ago. Zach Smith, the union's National Secretary, now assumes all senior powers and joins us live in Melbourne for more. Zach, good morning to you. How long have you been covering up your union's alleged corruption for?
Look, I'd say this right from the outset. The union has always said there is no place for criminality in our union. We have zero tolerance for criminality in our ranks. We have also always said if there are any credible allegations brought forward, the union will test them, and anyone who is found to have done the wrong thing will be removed from our ranks. Now, the allegations that have been aired by this Channel 9 investigation were only brought to the union late last week as part of their reporting. The union has covered nothing up. In fact, the union has taken the extraordinary step of placing the Victorian Tasmanian branch into administration so it can conduct a thorough investigation, an investigation that will be at arm's length and robust enough to hear any allegations, consider them properly, and then take any appropriate action.
So essentially you're taking the I know nothing defence.
Well, Carl, that's not an accurate reflection.
Well, it defies belief.
The union,
wait
a second. Yeah. Let's be very clear on this, right? You're putting words into my mouth, and that's not an accurate reflection of what I said.
Okay.
The union has zero tolerance for criminality.
Yeah.
We will investigate any allegations and deal with any wrongdoing. And the track record of this union, is that we have taken action and removed people in the past that have done the wrong thing. So you cannot legitimately accuse the union or any of our leaders of trying to cover up wrongdoing. But at the same time, we do need to have a process that is independent, that is robust enough to deal with the allegations, but also affords people the presumption of innocence and procedural fairness. And that's exactly what will happen under these arrangements.
It defies belief that you knew nothing about the allegations. So it's either complicit or just ignorant.
Well, I don't accept that at all. The allegations have been brought to us. We will respond to them.
Yeah.
We haven't tested the credibility of these allegations, and in some cases, there's a lack of information connecting it to the union that's been reported. Now, I'm taking every allegation seriously, and as part of this administration arrangement, they will all be investigated.
Okay. So, given you had no idea about any of this alleged corruption, how in any reasonable world can you be trusted in any credible way to conduct your own inquiry into your own union's alleged corruption?
Well, like I said, this investigation will have independence. This investigation will draw in outside expertise and legal advice and outside scrutiny to get to the bottom of any allegations.
How independent?
Also, but let's also, you want to talk about the credibility of the union. The track record of this union is that we have taken action on people within our ranks that have done the wrong thing in the past. This union has always acted swiftly where allegations have been sustained.
Okay.
Yeah.
Do you have any knowledge of the Victorian Premier and the Prime Minister being warned about CFMEU tactics? Is it feasible they didn't know?
The first I heard about that was this morning in this morning's media reporting.
The Thin Review sent questions to your union about your union's links to organised crime, which were leaked to an accused criminal with deep organised crime links. Did you know that that happened?
Again, I read it for the first time in today's media
report. Not just John Setka. New South Wales State Secretary Darren Greenfield is currently before the courts facing criminal allegations. The corruption clearly runs deep. Did you know about that?
Well, let's be very clear here. You say the corruption runs deep. Darren Greenfield has time and time again rejected any claims of corruption and is vigorously defending those charges, and has the full support of his membership and the branch management committee in that state.
Are you okay?
Yeah.
Okay. How much has the CFMEU donated to Labor since Anthony Albanese came into power?
I couldn't give you an exact figure.
It's 6.2 million?
I don't know where you've got that figure from. It sounds a bit too high for me, to my reckoning, but I don't have an exact figure for you, Carl.
You're the boss of the CFMEU now. You don't know how much you've donated to political parties?
I didn't know there was going to be a memory test here to rattle off
figures. Well, it's a compliance test. That's not a memory test. It's a compliance test.
Yeah, and we take compliance very seriously. We take our governance very seriously.
You don't know how much you've donated.
I don't have the exact figure off the top of my head.
Your union could well be deregistered after all of this. How do you feel about that?
Let's be very clear on that, though. Deregistration is a disaster for workers. What deregistration means is that workers in a dangerous, precarious industry like construction overnight would have their representation stripped away and be at the mercy of unscrupulous employers, bad safety. Anyone who's seriously contemplating deregistration needs to understand exactly what that means. It would be a disaster for workers and they would be the real victims under any such proposal.
It sounds like you're threatening now.
I'm not threatening. That's the reality, though, Carl. I think it's pretty ludicrous to say that was a threat. Deregistration would be a disaster for workers. They wouldn't have a voice on safety. They wouldn't have a voice on wages and conditions.
But haven't you brought that upon yourself?
No, not at all. We are capable and we are demonstrating that capability to investigate allegations and take action where there is any wrongdoing proven.
Let's see how it all shakes down. Appreciate you being on, fronting up. Thanks so much, Zach. Appreciate it.
Thanks, Carl.
And joining us now to discuss some of the local issues, Di Lee, Independent MP. Good morning to you, Di.
Good morning,
Carl. Does that make you feel like you want to do a big convention in Australia?
Oh, no, I don't think our people will be into those kind of big conventions.
and also Peter Gleeson joins us from the Gold Coast this morning too. Di, let's talk about the unions first up this morning here in Australia. The accusations get thicker and they're very, very difficult to handle, aren't they, from an outsider's perspective. How do you think the government's handling it and do you think the union should be deregistered?
Oh, look, I'm not surprised about the whole CFMEU. I know that in my area, in particular in Fowler, people in the construction industry have told me since my election how bad they are. They're thugs, they intimidate, standover tactics, especially dealing with a lot of the population that are of non-English speaking backgrounds. They're forced to join. So I think this is a great, day for people in you know, who work in that industry, who are seeing that, you know, that they're being called out for the things that they do.
A lot of allegations at the moment, but it looks as though something in the order of $6.2 million has been donated to the Labor Party alone since Albo's come into office from the CFMEU. That is not illegal.
No.
There are questions, obviously, about their conduct, about their tactics and about alleged corruption. Has the Labor Party done enough? Have authorities done enough to investigate?
Look, I don't know if the Labor Party's done enough. I mean, they should know that this is the kind of a lot of behaviour within some of the union movements, as we are aware of, and this has come to light now, which is great. Hopefully the Labor Party will do something about their own unions.
Gleeso, I mean, you hear anecdotally stories from Queensland all the time about this kind of behaviour, alleged behaviour. I think this story only gets bigger, but imagine if they had an inquiry where the public or companies could give evidence without fear or favour. Just imagine what would come out if people weren't scared to give evidence.
I think we need to turn the clock back to the 80s, Carl. If Bob Hawke can deregister the Builders Labours Federation, a former ACTU president, Anthony Albanese needs to deregister the CFMEU. Have a look what they do in here in Queensland, Carl. Every government-owned construction site, the cost of that particular project goes up by 30 or 40% because of the sweetheart deals that go on between the Miles government and, of course, the CFMEU. And if you want to have a think about just how powerful the union movement is in this country, and in particular Queensland, it was Gary Bullock, the head of the union movement up here in Queensland, that installed Stephen Miles as Premier of Queensland after they knifed Anastasia Palaszczuk in the back. So that's how powerful they are. The problem is that the Labor Party is a wholly owned subsidiary of the union movement and they derive most of their electoral war chest from the union movement. So you can expect the CFMEU to continue with their unabashed, illegal, unlawful activities going forward.
And the fallout will no doubt continue.